Well, let us see the average value of AC EMF over a complete cycle and a half cycle respectively. For a complete cycle, if you write the average value, we write it as integration 0 to 2 pi E0 sin omega t d omega t upon 2 pi. It is because for a complete cycle means 0 to t is the time period and t corresponds to 2 pi. So therefore, we integrate the value of the EMF signal E0 sin omega t throughout the entire interval 0 to 2 pi and divide it by 2 pi. That is how we estimate the average value over a complete cycle. And symbolically, we represent it that small e arrow bracket 1. So therefore, if you write small e arrow bracket 1, which is the average value of AC EMF over a complete cycle, can be written as equal to 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi E0 sin omega t d omega t. And E0 being constant, taken outside of the integrations, that will be sin omega t integration will be minus cos omega t and with limit 0 to 2 pi. And if you substitute the limit, it will be equal to E0 by 2 pi within bracket minus cos 2 pi minus of minus cos 0. So therefore, that will give you E0 by 2 pi and cos 2 pi being 1 will give you minus 1 and cos 0 again is 1. So therefore, within bracket minus 1 minus of minus 1, which will give you 0. So therefore, over a complete cycle, the average value of AC EMF is 0. In the same way, if you integrate, the average value of AC EMF over half cycle can be written as equal to 1 by pi 0 to pi integration E0 sin omega t d omega t. And again, E0 is taken outside and integration sin omega t is minus cos omega t with limit 0 to pi. So therefore, if you substitute the values of upper and lower limit, it will be equal to E0 by pi minus cos pi minus of minus cos 0, which will give you E0 by pi 1 minus of minus 1. So therefore, the value will be equal to twice E0 upon pi, which is the average value of AC EMF over half cycle. Now, if you see that the average value in case of a AC EMF over a complete cycle is 0. So therefore, we measure the RMS value for our convenience in measuring a record of the instruments. RMS means root mean square. We have to take the square of all the EMF signals, take the mean of these, and then the root over of all this mean we have taken. So what is this signal is E0 sin omega t. If you square it, that will be equal to E0 square sin square omega t. And you have to take the mean. Mean means you have to integrate throughout the entire integral over 0 to 2 pi if you are integrating through the complete cycle. So therefore, 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi E0 square sin square omega t d omega t, that is the mean square value of the RMS value. So therefore, we write it E RMS square. So E RMS square can be written as equal to 1 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi E0 square sin square omega t d omega t. And E0 square being constant, taken outside again. So E0 square by 2 pi integration 0 to 2 pi sin square omega t d omega t. And here we have multiplied in the numerator 2 and divided in the denominator with 2, with an objective that we can substitute in place of 2 sin square omega t as 1 minus cos 2 omega t, which is integrable. The function we want to make it integrable. So therefore, the 2 sin square omega t is replaced with 1 minus cos 2 omega t using the formula 1 minus cos 2 theta is equal to 2 sin square theta. That is the formula we have used. So therefore, the ERMS square, which we have written equal to E0 square by 2 pi integration of 0 to 2 pi within bracket 1 minus cos 2 omega t upon 2 d omega t. And if we separate the two parts of the integrands, then it will be equal to E0 square by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi d omega t upon 2 is first integrand. The second integral will be equal to minus half 0 to 2 pi cos 2 omega t d omega t. And if you integrate the cos 2 theta, which here is cos 2 omega t, over the complete cycle 0 to 2 pi, the integrand vanishes. And the corresponding integrations has been discussed in the chapters of integrations. So therefore, what remains is the first integrand, that is E0 by 2 pi 0 to 2 pi d omega t by 2, which will give you E0 square by 2 pi into half 2 pi, because the integrand of d omega t over 0 to 2 pi will give you only 2 pi. So therefore, the value you will get E0 square by 2 pi, 2 E0 square by 2, which is equal to ERMS square. Now, ERMS must be square root of this one. So therefore, ERMS equal to E0 by root 2, which will be equal to 0.707 E0. In the same way, we can find out the IRMS, which is equal to I0 by 2 root 2. So therefore, this is how we can find out the RMS value of AC. Now, the important characteristics, if you see to the RMS value of AC component, is that the RMS value is independent of frequency of the waves, and it depends only on peak value of current. For example, that is I equal to twice cos 512 t plus 3 cos 10240 plus 4 cos 15760. These three components of I1, I2, I3 we add to get I, which is the resultant currents. In each of these I1, I2, I3, the RMS value we can write is I1 RMS is equal to 2 by root 2, because the magnitude is E0 y E01 is equal to 2, and E02 being 3, E03 being 4. So therefore, I1 RMS can be written as 2 by root 2, I2 RMS can be written as 3 by root 2, and I3 RMS can be written as equal to 4 by root 2. So here, the net IRMS can be written as square root of I1 RMS square plus I2 RMS square plus I3 RMS square, and I1 RMS, I2 RMS, I3 RMS, as we have seen, equal to 2 by root 2, 3 by root 2 and 4 by root 2 respectively. So substituting these values, we will get that IRMS is equal to square root of 4 by 2 plus 9 by 2 plus 16 by 2, which will be equal to square root of 29 by 2 is the value of IRMS. So here, if you see, the RMS is obviously independent of frequency. It never depends upon the frequency, which is here 512T, 10240, 15760. This is being phase factor containing the frequency 512, 1024 and 1576, which never comes in our calculations. So therefore, RMS is independent of frequency. Now the form factor, which is an important indicator of waveforms, is written as K subscript F is equal to ratio of IRMS upon I average, and IRMS is I0 by root 2 and I average is 2I0 by pi. So therefore, substituting, the form factor can be written as pi by 2 root 2, which equal to 1.11. And if the form factor is greater than 1.11, obviously wave has sharp peak as shown in the picture, and if it is less than 1.11, it has a flat peak. Similarly, the amplitude factor can be calculated to be equal to Ka, which is equal to I peak by IRMS, and substituting the value, we substitute IRMS, that is I0 by root 2, so therefore amplitude factor can be written equal to root 2. This is how the average value and the characteristics